What's up, guys? Welcome back to Trove. Welcome back to my starting from scratch series. Well, actually, from scratch series. Call it just that. We're definitely done with the starting part. Anyway, today, guys, we are gonna take care of our weekly Shadow Towers. Question is, can I solo hard mode? Let's see. Apparently, for Weeping Prophet, recommended power rank, well, actually, not recommended, but they ask you to be at least 1,200 power rank. What about Daughter of the Moon, 2.5k? Does that mean that 8 people, each being 2.5k power rank, are gonna be able to solo Daughter of the Moon on hard mode? Well, I don't know, cause if that's the case, I think I should do just fine. Let's try Spike. Well, updates time. In the end, I just decided to ask for people to join, because otherwise it's gonna take a lot. Oh, looks like my Dragon Coin Tome is done. Nice. I think I'm getting closer and closer to finishing the Neon Dragon, this time the right one. Wow, we already have a nice team. There's Chow. Actually, let me just type slash who and shout outs to all of these awesome people. Going with the team definitely makes things much faster. I'm only praying to have enough keys. Oh my god, I don't have keys. Or did I miss them? Come on. Do I seriously... Oh my god, I seriously don't have any keys I can use. But I farmed a lot, are you kidding me? Can I make maybe these? Okay, okay, we're good. Time for Weeping Prophet. What a nice random golden piña party. Thanks to whoever dropped it. And through the magic of editing, we are already on hard mode, Daughter of the Moon floor. Let's finish this. Shadow Towers for this week are now completed. Thank you all so much for helping. Let me claim my goodies and open some empowered gems. Let's see, what can we make? We can make some shadow. No, we can only make one. Eh, whatever, put it next to the others. I should probably sell them. Oh, and actually, speaking of selling, I totally forgot, after selling my Trove of Wonder, to place that panda talisman on the marketplace again. Let me just check its price again. Panda tally. I'm pretty sure I had a different one, not one that's this expensive. Corgi talisman, maybe. Yeah, 10k, perfect. Where's my talisman at? Nice. Give me that flux. No! Put it for 10k. Okay. Now, back to the Shadowy cache. What can we get? Titan Souls. Can we unlock? We can get some sales, I suppose. Or 24 caches. Is this a costume? No, it's an ally. Ally. Weeping Prophet shield. How much mastery for a sale again? I mean, it's pretty expensive. 21 souls. Shadow Hydrogen. Apparently it's only 10 mastery points, so I'm not gonna use my souls on it, but instead I'm tempted to try getting the other ones. These are like 50 mastery points each. How much are Hearts of Darkness? Probably a lot. They probably cost hearts, man. Heart. They probably cost a lot. Heart of... There you go. Wow, 1.6. Okay. Yeah, maybe later. But what about our disp... Wow, we can get another costume. This is great. Which one should we pick? What is our next class gonna be? What should we play next? I should probably make a poll with this. And I know there's still a long way up to level 30 on this class, but we need to prepare in advance. For example, now I need to buy... Well, actually craft a new costume. Which class should I craft it for? Maybe the Ice Sage? My first magical damage dealing class? Where is its costume? There you go. Let's make it. Why not? 130 mastery. What did we get? A stupid ally. Okay. Now that we're done with our dispel divinity, let's make how many? Three. Only three, really? Anyway, we got three empowered gem boxes to open. We can't use golden keys on these, right? I'm pretty sure we cannot. Okay, well, I can only wish myself good luck right now, so good luck to me, fingers crossed, hoping for stellar empowered gems.